Testing of laser toner cartridge, service level setting, service manual reading and driver installation. In this lecture, we are going to study laser toner cartridge testing procedure, service manual setting and driver installation procedure for repairing and maintaining a printer. Let us begin with understanding the different components of a printer and their uses. You can see the cross-sectional view of a laser printer where you can clearly see the toner cartridge indicated with blue segment. To test the cartridge, there is a method popularly known as halfway cartridge testing method. For performing this test, firstly give a print command and open the toner lid when the paper is underneath the toner cartridge. This will stop the printing and you can pull the toner cartridge out. Now print a test from this tray which fold down on your printer. After this, open the toner lid door, which results in stopping of print command sensing an error. Now, pull the toner cartridge out and you will notice the test page is under the toner. Pull the page upward and remove it. Now, examine the print out. If there is print defect on your test page, it means the defect is being added later in this print process by the fuser. If the print defect is visible on this printout, then it means the print defect is occurring before the fuser. Now, you need to replace toner cartridge. Let us look at driver installation process for repairing and maintaining a printer. Driver installation is performed by connecting USB cable to printer and computer. Firstly, connect the power cord to the printer, go to printer control panel and select your language and country, then click on continue, also select your time zone and then press continue. After this, make your network cable connected to printer and turn on printer and go to control panel, select your language and country and then click on continue and now install the software. Now look for IP address. For this purpose, use network setup page. Let us understand the concept of raw file format. A PRN file is a special type of file which contains instructions for a printer. It tells the printer what to print on the page and where, as well as which paper tray to use, what the paper size is and a number of other controls. PRN files are usually created automatically by a printer driver. In fact, this is the primary purpose of the printer driver. Capturing a PRN file is quite straightforward. Most applications offer a print to file option when you open the normal print dialog. If your application does not support the print to file option, then you could create a printer which uses the file and port, or even use some software such as Print Distributor, which offers a very flexible solution for capturing print file. You can see the image where the virtual printer looks exactly same as a normal printer and makes the whole system very reliable and support free. Now have a look on these instructions for service manual IP setting. Firstly, go to the control panel and press OK. Now select network configuration and then press OK. Again select CFGTCP/IP and then press OK. Select boot P and make sure the value is no, and then press OK and select DHCP and make sure the value is no, and then press OK. Select IP byte 1 and then press OK. Change the value of IP byte 1 and then press OK. Also repeat step for the subnet mask, and default gateway are GW byte 1, GW byte 2, GW byte 3, GW byte 4. After performing the following procedure, a print network report page as follows. Press OK and press the down arrow to select reports and then press OK. The printer has four interface ports, out of which one is EIO slot for connecting to a computer or network, as you can see marked in the image. Use the embedded web server, that is EWS, to view printer and network status and to manage printing function from your computer instead of from the printer control panel. The settings tab contain configure device, which configure all printer settings from this page. This page contains the traditional menus found on printer that use a control panel display. These menus include information, paper handling and configure devices. Alerts are for network only, which are set up to receive email alert for various printer and supply events. Security, as it set a password that must be typed in order to gain access to the settings and networking tab. Turn on and off certain features of the EWS. Other links such as to add or customize a link to another website, which is shown in the other links area on all embedded web server pages. Other links area are HP Instant Support, Order Supplies and Product Support. Device information is to give name, the printer and assign an asset number to it. Type the name and email address for the primary contact who will receive information about the printer. Networking tab is to control network related setting for the printer when it is connecting to an IP based network. This tab will not appear if the printer is directly connected to a computer. If the printer is connected to a network with anything other than the HP Jet Direct print server. Toolbox is used to check the printer status, configure the printer setting to view troubleshooting information and online documentation. You can view the HP Toolbox when the printer is directly connected to your computer or when it is connected to the network. You must perform a complete software installation in order to use the HP Toolbox. You can see and listed different components of a laser printed which coordinator with each other and maintain function and working of a printer successful. In laser printer, various technologies are used to produce a printed page. Let us understand the image formation that take place in a laser printer. There are many processes which creates an image and each process function independently and must be coordinated with the other printer processes. Electrostatic latent image formation, developing, transfer, fusing, drum cleaning are the process involved in image formation. In older printer, a corona wire positioned parallel to the drum, or in more recent printers, a primary charge roller projects and charge onto the photoreceptor. A revolving photosensitive drum or belt, which is capable of holding an electrostatic charge on its surface while it is in the dark. An AC bias is applied to the primary charger roller to remove any residual charges left by previous image. The roller will also apply a DC bias on the drum surface to ensure a uniform negative potential. Numerous patents describe the photosensitive drum coating as a silicon sandwich with a photocharging layer, a charger leakage barrier layer, as well as surface layer. One version uses an amorphous silicon containing hydrogen as the light receiving layer, boron nitride as a charge leakage barrier as layer, as well as surface layer of doped silicon or nitrogen, which at sufficient concentration resembles machining silicon nitride. The laser is aimed at a rotating polygonal mirror which directs the laser beam through a system of lenses and mirror onto the photoreceptor. The cylinder continues to rotate during the sweep and the angle of sweep compensates for this motion. The stream of rasterized data held in memory turns the laser on and off to form the dots on the cylinders. Lasers are used because they generate a narrow beam over great distance. The laser beam neutralizes the charges on the back part of the image, leaving a static electric negative image on the photoreceptor surface to lift the toner particles. The surface with the latent image is exposed to toner. Fine particles of dry plastic powder mixed with carbon black or coloring agents. The toner particles are given as negative charge and are electrostatically attracted to the photoreceptor latent image, the areas touched by the laser. Because like charges repel, the negatively charged toner will not touch the drum where the negative charge remains. The paper passes through roller in the fuser assembly where heat up to 200 degrees Celsius and pressure bond the plastic powder to the paper. One roller is usually a hollow tube and the other is a rubber backing roller. A radiant heat lamp is suspended in the center of the hollow tube and it is infrared energy uniformly heats and roller from the inside. For proper bonding of the toner, the diffuser roller must be uniformly hot. Some printer uses a very thin flexible metal fuser roller and there is less mass to heat it and the fuser can more quickly reach operating temperature. If paper moves through the fuser more slowly, there is more roller contact time for the toner to melt and fuser can operate at a lower temperature. Smaller inexpensive laser printer typically print slowly due to this energy saving design compared to large high speed printer where paper moves more rapidly through a high temperature fuser with a very short contact time. Thank you.